All right, so how do we say half of a quantity? That would be one half x. And so let's take a look at all the different places where we might encounter stuff like that. So before we can do the one half, let's just look at area of a parallelogram. So let's review what shape parallelogram is. A parallelogram is a shape with two pairs of parallel segments. So you have that segment is parallel, that segment and that segment are parallel. Now I want to compute the area of that. So we only know how to find area of rectangles. So maybe we can cut this up and let's say the height of a parallelogram is defined as the length of the perpendicular drop from any vertex to the opposite base. And so when you do that, this height is going to play a role into how we find area of parallelogram. Let's take a look how. I can take that piece and cut it from the parallelogram and move it here. I can take that piece and move it here. So there's my parallelogram, but this is still a parallelogram, so I'm just going to move this. So again, this is my B, and this height is my H, and now I suddenly have a rectangle. So area of a rectangle is that length times that length, so that's B times H. So area of a parallelogram is the base times height. Base times height is area of parallelogram. All right, let's take a look at area of a triangle. If I want area of a triangle, and remember I can use parallelograms now, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to take this shape and place it here, and you can see that makes it a parallelogram. So if this, so this part here is basically half of a parallelogram, and you can see that this height, same as parallelogram height, and it's also the same as the height of that triangle. So the height remains the same no matter where you are in a parallelogram. That's because these two segments are parallel. So the area of a triangle is going to be what? Half base times height. Let's look at trapezoid. Remember, trapezoid has exactly one pair of parallel lines. So area of this triangle is half base times height. And so that's the base and that's the height for this triangle. All right, so take a look at this triangle. This triangle has the same height as this one because if I move that height here, look. You see how it's the same? So I can put these together and you can see how this triangle plus that triangle makes this trapezoid up here. And I already know how to find area of a triangle. So this is half A times H, this is half B times H, and then we add them together. So area of a trapezoid is given by this formula, okay? So let's see, how would you write 6 more than twice the quantity? You would write 6 plus, so more means plus, twice means 2x. So that would be a combination of what we did before. Let's say I have a situation where I have a bucket and there is water dripping. All right, so I have 6 liters of water that I've already collected in the bucket. And the bucket is filling up. So you have 2 liters, another 2 liters in the next hour, and then it just keeps filling at the rate of 2 liters per hour. And I want to know after so many hours, like say after T hours, how much water is in here. Since it's 2 liters for every T hours, 2T is the amount of water that's filled into this bucket. So we would write that as what? 6 plus 2T liters. If I want R percent of a quantity, you would translate that into R percent. We saw percents is a fraction over 100. So R over 100 times X. So 30% of X would be 30 over 100 times X or 0.30X. X is less than Y, so that would be just less than symbol. So example would be 3 is less than 10, so I would write it like this. But what if I say X less than Y? Not X is less than, but X less than Y. That would mean subtract X from Y. So if I say give me a number that is 2 less than 8. Okay, 2 less than 8, so that would be 8, 7, 6. So you're going to go backwards 2, so 8 minus 2 or 6. More formulas you might want to make sure you know that are in the book, because there's lots of homework exercises in there for you. So take a look in the book. It would look like this, the summary of all the different geometric formulas that you might want to look at. We've already done all the way up to here. The only thing we haven't done was volume of a cylinder and volume of a cube and pyramid and sphere, but you can do that on your own. This section has lots of homework. Make sure you do all of it.